been together for a while now. We're growing stronger every day now. It feels so good and there is no doubt I will stay with you. As each morning brings the sunrise and the flowers bloom in springtime, on my loving you can rely, and I'll stay with you. Oh, I will stay with you.
That's actually,
it's so pretty.
Yes.
Oh, I will stay with you when no one else.
Cry.
It's so pretty. I love you so much.
I love you too.
I'm sorry.
Stay by your side, and I know we'll be alright. I will stay with you. Ooh. Ooh. Though relationships can get old, they have the tendency to grow cold. Have something like a miracle, yeah, and I'll stay with you.
Can I put it on?
Yes.
Okay. You
through the ups and the downs, yes, I will stay.
Our money.
Yeah, it's a luggage tag.
Ooh.
For later.
In the watch.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
I will stay by your side. I know we'll be alright. I will stay with you. And there'll be heartaches and pain. Yes, it will. Through it all, we will remain.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to witness the marriage of Chakira and Joshea and to ask God to bless them. It is an occasion which is both solemn, as we reflect on the seriousness of their decision, and festive, as we share their joy. Our service is based on the relationship which Chakira and Joshea share, and in on their faith in God. We affirm their love for each other as part of God's will for them. Who presents this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Let us pray. O gracious and everlasting God, look mercifully upon this man and this woman who come to you seeking your blessing, and assist them with your grace, that with true fidelity and steadfast love they may honor and keep the promises they make. They affirm that your gracious presence and power are needed for them to keep their vows and to continue to live in love. We know human commitment is fragile and human love imperfect, but your promise is eternal and your love can bring love to perfection. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hear these words of Scripture. They are found in Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 12, verses 9 and 10. Let love be genuine. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. When we got together, we gave them some homework. They had to answer two questions. Why am I marrying my fiancé? And why do I think my fiancé is marrying me? Well, I'm going to give you their answers. They wrote it separate. They sent it to me, so this will be the first time they hear and you hear. The meaning of the given name Chakira represents compassion, creativity, reliability, generosity, loyalty, and a love for domestic life. Family takes always priority in your life. Amen. It is the foundation of your traditional values. Now, Josh, Chakira wrote that she is marrying you because you are her person in every sense of the word. She hopes that you're up for this adventure. Even if it means facing your fears is in the equation. You have given Chakira many life adventures. You, Josh, have always encouraged her to be the best version of herself and to reach her goals, even when she felt like giving up. Chakira wrote that you help her to not take things too seriously and to enjoy the present moment. You always support her through her high and her low points. Josh believes that you love her for who she is as a person and always gives her extra love when her self-love is low. She thinks you are a true gentleman and you have extended your love to her family and friends. You have the same values, and marrying you today will continue on the path of being the best version of yourselves. Now, why is Josh marrying me? Chakira wrote that she believes that you would say, Chakira is my peace. She knows that you, Joshea, will find her as a listening ear at the end of a long day. Chakira believes you are marrying her because she always keeps your best interest at heart, and she is your best cheerleader. Josh, she's marrying you because you'll always be there for you, and she'll be there for you in the good and the bad and help push you to reach your goals regardless of the obstacles that may be in your way. Chakira is committed to you as a couple and committed to your future. Now, the meaning of the given name Joshea represents power, practicality, ambition, success, inspiration, and discipline. That's what your name means, Joshea. It takes hard work and effort on your part. Nothing is more common than people who have wasted their potential. One of your best qualities is to achieve your goals by working hard. Now, why does Joshea want to marry you, Chakira? Here we go. He wrote that the question was hard because there were over 100 reasons why he shouldn't. And then again, he sells himself short because he knows exactly why he wants to marry you, Chakira. He said that from the very first day he met you, he has been obsessed with you. Yeah, because you are a ravishing beauty. You have a brilliant mind. And you have ability to make light of situations you both get into. But you are serious in nature, not like him. And he is astonished how your opposites attract. You make him laugh. You're always there for him through thick and thin, from his darkest moments to the longest days that he gets to share with you. You are the yin to his yang. And he has a forever love that says he will never find another like you. Now the question is, why is Chakira marrying me? Josh wrote, because you, Chakira, believe in him and you share similar aspirations for each other and what you both want to create. She helps you, Josh, to be the best person you can be and helps you have faith and patience for everyone around him. Chakira, Josh believes you are so much more than your worth, and no one will ever understand your greatness. Josh wrote, I will forever push myself to be the person I need to be for you. So what will you need to be successful? Your love for each other must be genuine. And you're on your way. You love each other with mutual affection, being one in spirit and one in purpose. Marriage is a journey that will have moments of fun and some hardships, but keep walking together. Stop and notice how far you've come. Celebrate that with each other in big and small ways. God brought you two together. And I pray that together the life you have together will be more thrilling than you can possibly imagine. Amen? At this time, I'd like the families to please stand. The family of Joshea and the family of Shakira. You see, the union of Joshea and Shakira brings together two family traditions, two systems of roots, in the hope that a new family tree will become strong and fruitful. Theirs is a personal choice and a decision for which they are responsible. Yet their lives will be enriched by the support of the families from which each one comes. So let me ask the family, will you encourage Joshea and Shakira in their marriage? If so, say, we do. Do you celebrate with them the decision they have made to choose each other? If so, say, we do. Like good wine, a great love will deepen and mature with age. As part of today's ceremony, Joshea and Shakira have captured their thoughts leading up to this day in personal notes to each other. Also, they have asked their parents to compose notes as well, containing their thoughts and their most important peace advice to the couple as they journey through life together. These notes will be sealed in this box to be opened and shared together with a bottle of wine on every anniversary celebration. It is at this time I would ask the parents to come forward and place their note by the box.
You wrote this. It's pretty long.
You figured.
Because you basically, literally, have actually have been having this progression to grow from birth, basically. So,
Dad,
it's pretty long.
Gosh, I already cried enough.
Well, you're thank you.
Very proud of you. Thank you.
Thank you.
All that you are and all I know that you will be.
Thank you.
You got you.
I just got to make a party. I'm sorry.
Don't worry about that.
So, come here, Mom.
You made good choices.
Make good choices all the time.
Yeah, get in the circle.
Yeah, I'll take care of it.
Joshea?
Yes, ma'am.
Give my daughter to you, William. I told you before. I loved you from the first day I met you.
I
still love you. I will continue to love you.
I'll
love my daughter.
I will.
Take care of my daughter.
I now ask that Shakira and Joshea place their letters to each other with a bottle of wine into the box. On that joyous day next year, they will get to reflect on the events and emotions they shared on this wonderful day. Or if you ever find your marriage in serious trouble, the wine and love letters will be there to help. Before making any rash choices or rash decisions to separate, Joshea and Shakira have promised to open the box, drink the wine together, and read the letters that they and their parents wrote to each other in preparation for their nuptials as a reminder of their love.
In this moment, this feeling that I feel is breathtaking. As we stand before our family and friends, and I gaze into your eyes, getting ready to pledge our future together. There's only one thing I keep thinking. Is it too late to get eloped? But no, not really. What I'm really thinking is how incredibly blessed I am to get to spend the rest of my life with the best friend. This beautiful, strong person. I promise to make you laugh every day and make sure you smile through the pain. Yeah.
Joshea, I am so grateful that God brought our paths together, as I cannot imagine, sir, navigating through life with anyone else. You are my best friend, favorite travel buddy, confidant, and goofy goober. Thank you for loving me for all that I am and for pushing me to value myself as much as I value everyone else. I love how fiercely you love your family and how you have extended that same love to my family and friends. Today, in front of our friends and family, I choose you to be my husband. I promise to continue to choose you each day, whether it be the happiest or one filled with obstacles. I promise to put my faith in you, even though it is hard for me to manage surprises. I promise to continuously work on myself and challenge you to do the same. I promise to never go to bed without telling you I love you. I promise to never take our time together for granted. I promise to be your forever partner, even if that means living in Ohio. No matter what, I will love you for the rest of my life.
I love you.
Joshea, before God, will you have this woman to be your wife? And do you commit yourself to her to be responsible in the marriage relationship? To give yourself to her in love and work? To invite her fully into your being so that she can know who you are? To cherish her above all others and respect her individuality, encouraging her to be herself and to grow in all that God intends? If so, say, I do.
I do.
Chakira, before God, will you have this man to be your husband? And do you commit yourself to him to be responsible in the marriage relationship, to give yourself to him in love and work, to invite him fully into your being so that he can know who you are, to cherish him above all others and to respect his individuality, encouraging him to be himself and to grow in all that God intends? If so, say, I do.
I do.
What do you bring as a symbol of your promise? These rings represent, by the circle of these rings, an everlasting, everlasting love that never ends. Let's pray. By your blessing, O God, may these rings be to Joshea and Chakira symbols of unending love and faithfulness, reminding them of the covenant they have made this day. Amen. Repeat after me. Chakira.
Chakira.
Okay.
I love you.
I love you.
And I give you this ring.
And I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all I am.
And with all I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I will honor you.
Joshea.
Joshea.
I love you.
I love you.
And I give you this ring.
And I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
Let us pray. O God, without your grace, no promise is sure. Strengthen Joshea and Chakira in the gifts of your Spirit so that they may fulfill the vows they have taken. Keep them faithful to each other and to you. Fill them with such love and joy that they may build a home where no one is a stranger, and guide them by your word to serve you all the days of their life. In the name of the Savior, amen. Based on your promise to one another in the covenant of marriage and have declared your love before God and these witnesses, I now pronounce you to be husband and wife. Those whom God has joined, let no one pull asunder. Joshea, you may kiss your bride. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. May you dwell in God's presence forever. May true and constant love preserve you. Amen. It is my great honor to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Joshea and Chakira Washington.
Tomorrow, let's do it tonight. body sexy, tell them hey. Give me everything tonight. Give me everything tonight. Give me everything tonight. Give me everything tonight.
Take advantage of the night, cause tomorrow I'm off to Dubai to perform for a princess. But tonight I can make you my queen and make love to you endless. It's insane the way the name growing, money keep flowing. Hustlers moving silent, so I'm tiptoeing. So keep blowing, I got it locked up like Lindsay Lohan. Put it on my life, baby. I'm gonna give you a ride, baby. Can't promise tomorrow, but I promise tonight.
Die. Excuse me, and I might drink a little more than I should tonight. And I might take you home with me if I could tonight. And baby, I'ma make you feel so good. Might not get tomorrow.
Top of your girl. What I'm involved with is deeper than the Masons, baby, baby, and it ain't no secret. My family's from Cuba, but I'm an American. I don't get money like secrets. Put it on my life, baby. I make it feel right, baby. Can't promise tomorrow, but I promise tonight.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Yeah, yeah, yeah. No. Yeah. I know sometimes it might not be the perfect one, yeah. And sometimes you even think that we don't belong together. But if you give me one chance, I'll let you say in my arms, baby, yeah. That's where you belong, yeah. For so long, my lady, I've been hoping for this song, yeah. We do things no one, no other. We say some bad things to each other too.
We be
perfect, but there's not another you, and there's not another me. This is mine, it's truth. I could never be tired of you. In my own, where you belong, yeah. For so long, my lady, I've been hoping for this song, yeah. If I could change this wave, baby, I would. Never ever felt this way before. Was worth it. You, I know, I will settle the score in my arms, baby. That's where you belong.
I guess by now you guys know who I am, primarily because all of Shakira's adult life, I was told we look identical. Unfortunately, I have yet to see the resemblance, but that's what I was told. In any case, I would like to basically, on behalf of her mom, Irma, Josh's dad, stepmom, and his mom to welcome you guys all here to celebrate Josh's and Shakira's basically future together as of today. Shakira is a very determined and independent kid. Yeah, still my kid, will always be. From the moment, she deciding basically when she should enter this world. From that moment on, I had actually made myself a promise to always protect you from all others and encourage you as well. And from that moment on, you've actually made me proud up to this point, actually, where you've actually made that decision to say yes to Josh. And throughout the years, basically, there have been many situations and instances, basically, whereby you've actually showed me who you are as a person, who you've actually grown to be. From our moments, basically, of actually struggling together over math homework because I thought you couldn't understand these basic concepts, but somehow you finally figured it out. As you said, you like statistics in college. I don't know how that happened, but that's the way that's how it started. To watching you dance here tonight with Joshua and taking me back to your very first recital in your pink and white polka dot dress, doing your similar dance here as well. The memories keep flowing, basically, up to the point. Some of the other instances that I can recall to show you as a person and your growth throughout your life is this one in particular that I always remember. I remember I got a call to say, hey, Dad, I'm playing basketball for my church team. And I was like, you're doing what? Playing basketball? You never took the ball from me in the garage or in the driveway. And when I showed up to the game, I was late as usual, but you already know that's going to occur. And your coach has put you on the best player on the opposing team, probably because you were the tallest kid on your team. And I know you haven't even touched a basketball before in your life. So I was actually very impressed and very proud to see you basically taking... stepping out of the box and what, basically, to show your support for your friends, and in this case, your church family, and playing basketball, and defending the best player, and not knowing what you were doing, you looked at me in the I won't say the stands, but on the side, for some guidance, and I just simply told you, just put one foot on the key and keep the lady in front of you. And your experience there, basically, the girl didn't even score a point when you were guarding her. I don't know how it happened, but it just showed basically some of your, no. You did a good job, that's why. From that point on, I was actually extremely proud and impressed with the fact that you actually stepped out of your comfort zone, did something you've never done before, and actually put your best foot forward. And you carry that on throughout your entire life in everything you do. From the point of, there's other instances, I might have been not be present at the time, but I have heard you've actually went out of your way to basically spend as much time as possible with your friends or associates, basically, to make sure that they're ever actually happy. Hearing your vows to Josh this evening actually just took me back to all those moments, basically, to see who you were and see how you've actually grown, and seeing that everything that you were taught as a kid, not by me personally, but by your mom, I was just there to support and say yes and no to everything. But by your mom, to see you have actually grown into her very beautiful young lady. As I said before, you know, every dad's job is to protect their kid or their daughter in particular. So when Shakira gave me a call several years ago to say, Dad, I've got a boyfriend. And I said, you got a what? Don't you know the rule? There's no boys in your life, basically. And she said, she actually ignored me. She just carried on to the conversation. Yes, I have a boyfriend. And I was like, who is he? His name is Joshea. I was like, Joshea? What? I've never heard that name before. And she's like, ah, yeah, that's his name, Joshea. So I'm like, tell me about him. Oh, he's tall. Okay. So I said, tall? She said, yeah, I have to make sure I have someone who's tall enough to be with me so when I put my heels on, I'm not towering over them. So I was like, oh, man, okay, fine. You've always made good decisions, so if this is the guy that you claimed is your boyfriend, you can go ahead and go along with it. I wasn't happy about it, quite honestly. It's only up until a couple of hours ago, I am like, so I'm going to just skip ahead because I know I told you I wasn't going to embarrass you, but it's my job to do that. Up to the point, was it 2 years ago, roughly? I got a call from Josh A. And he asked for Shakira's hand in marriage. And I was like, are you sure this is what you want to do? Now, I said that because I know Shakira. Shakira is somewhat like me, have some very quirky ways, and is difficult to get along with. So I just had to ask these questions. So I have to ask him, did you talk to Shakira about this? And he said, no, not yet. And I said, well, if Shakira says yes, it's okay, because as I said again, she always make very good decisions in their life. But before you do that, you should probably consult with her mother first, right? I don't know if he did or not, and quite frankly, it doesn't really matter anymore. I said that basically is up based on his upbringing from his mom and his parents, to show me some respect, to say basically that you would like to actually take Shakira's hand in marriage. Her mom has always said that she liked you from the first time she saw you. I am not that guy. I just stand back and I keep my eyes on you. Protecting the little one here. So, but if that said, basically, I have actually gotten to know you somewhat, basically, and I've found basically you to be a very kind and loving person, basically. And all I ask from Shakira is to find someone who is respectful of you and will like you I don't like to use the word love, but will love you for who she is and not what they would expect you to be. She made that decision. It's a great, in my opinion, it's a very great decision. I would like to just take this time now to say congratulations. I was actually very impressed with your vows to each other. I was also extremely impressed with basically your notes to each other as to why you are going to want to marry each other and why you think each other should marry you. I don't want to repeat most of them. I had thought of most, just with everything you had said, and I didn't want to say that tonight, but you said it earlier, so I will not repeat that. So with that saying, I will just give you my family advice, as always. I know you're very independent, and I know that whenever we give you the information, we leave it up to you to make the decision. And that also impressed me. But always remember this. Always do everything within your power to listen with the intent to understand, and not with the intent to respond or reply. So it's always more important to understand what it is, and once you've done that, you would actually have a great life together. So with that, to Shakira and Josh, cheers.
All right, everybody. Now that we have welcomed the new Mr. and Mrs. Washington, of whom I am very proud. I was proud of my daughter from the time she was 2 years old. I said, from the time you were 2 years old, I said, I was very proud of you. I answered, hello. There's so much that has happened in between and along the way. She's proven to be such a great person, very independent. And if I ever wanted honest criticism, I can ask Shakira, because she is brutally honest. And even if I might feel it, she will just preface it by saying, Mom, I don't mean to hurt your feelings, but, and you know what? Most times she's always absolutely right. I might be going at Mom, and you know you don't want to do it right now, but when you go and think about it, you know what? That kid was absolutely right, Mom. You need to step back and just take it in. So for that, I'm very proud. And I'm sure with that she will honor Josh. She will listen to him. She will help him. And he will do the same for her. With all that said, I think it's time for us to start eating. And I will invoke God's blessing upon what we are about to partake of. Okay. Our dear Heavenly Father, as we gather in thy presence on this beautiful occasion, we invoke thy presence and thy blessing upon this couple. Yes. We ask that you bless every one of us who were here to witness this auspicious occasion, Father. Guide them, guard them, protect them. We pray that they will come to you in their time of need and that they will keep you in their midst. Heavenly Father, you brought these two young people together for a purpose, and I pray that I will be around to see what that purpose might be. I pray at this time that you will bless all that we are going to partake of. And when we do leave here, that you will take us back to our destinations in safety. And these things we humbly pray for in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Olivia, best friend of the beautiful bride for almost our whole lifetime. Through our many years of friendship, our relationship has not changed. Although I probably will never forgive you for moving to Ohio. Not many people can say that they've had one best friend for a lifetime, but we are blessed enough that we can. I'm sorry. I wish I hadn't had more time to share the many memories that we've had together, ups and downs, highs and lows. We've seen it all. I truly believe that each person we cross paths with in this life is for a reason, to teach a lesson, whether that is valuable or irrelevant. There's a reason. Shakira taught me that only the truest friends become family. Shakira and Josh, as you begin this new chapter of your lives, know that you were placed in one another's lives for this reason: to care for one another, to grow, to comfort, to laugh, to learn, and to love. Cheers to your love and the many blessings on your path ahead. Cheers.
I've been knowing Joshea for 15, 16 years. This man would be 13, 14 years old, cutting grass, doing anything under the sun to make a buck, hustling. Sometimes Joshua can be a handful, definitely, but he's probably the most kind-hearted person I ever came across, for real. He put others first before putting himself first. Boy. Boy. He touched so many hearts. If you know anything about Joshea, he's definitely weird. I told you, I'm on your ass.
Leave me alone.
But above all, he's definitely a good, a great human being. I just want to say congratulations to both of y'all and to many more.
Thank you,
cheers.
Well, you pop and roll, that's how we go. Well, it to you gently. We gon' do more than kick it like Jet Li.
Watch out, watch out.
But you gon' come before I do, don't stress me.
Asking, is it you?
Is it you?
Is it me?
Is it me?
Say it's us.
Say it's us.
And I'll agree, baby.
Just jump in a Cadillac.
Girl, let's put some miles on it.
Anything you want.
Just to put a smile on it.
Oh, yeah.
You deserve it, baby. You deserve it all. And I'm gonna give it to you.
Gold jewelry shining so bright.
So
strawberry champagne on us.
Yeah, yeah.
Lucky for you, that's what I like.
That's what I like.
Lucky for you,
like.
That's what I like. That's what I like.
That's what I like.
For you, that's what I like. That's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like.